With Blazor, you never have to use JavaScript for web apps again, right? Well, though many may wish for it, it is not the reality. There will always be times where you need to work with JavaScript in a Blazor project. For example, if you want to display maps in your web application, you may want to use OpenLayers, a very popular framework. But can this work? I have tried it. Let's go. Before we get started, there are a few things we need to get straight. OpenLayers is an open source framework based on JavaScript. This means we have to write JavaScript code to interact with the map. We cannot control the map directly from C#, so we first have to write the JS code, and then we have to make sure that we can call that code from C#. This is necessary for any JavaScript framework we want to use in Blazor. So I have this nice little sample project that I got by creating a new project in Visual Studio. This creates this typical example with the calendar and the weather information. I extended this project by creating a new Razor component called Simple Map, which is a new page where I want to show my map. For this, I placed a div with an ID where OpenLayers will render the map. The next step is to actually integrate OpenLayers into the project. I've made it a bit easy for myself here. I'm just loading the OpenLayers.js and CSS file directly from the CDN into the index.html file. Maybe you want to integrate it via npm and then use webpack or wheat or something like that, but I don't think we need that for our example. Then we need to initialize the map. To do this, I'll create a JS file where I'll put all the JS code for the map. Here I create an initMap function that expects the ID of the div where the map should be rendered. And then I create the OpenLayers map with an OpenStreetMap layer and a vector layer with an initial view. I call this JS function in the simple map component on the first render. I inject the JS runtime object, which allows me to call a JavaScript function. This should be enough to see the map when we run the project. The next thing I wanted to try was calling a C# function from JavaScript. So I created these event handlers on the map object to handle clicks in the map and banning zooming in the map. In both cases, I wanted to call a C# function, and that's where it got a little tricky. I tried a few options to solve this, and in the end, this was the solution that worked for me. I created a JS function called RegisterClass, which registers any object on the window object with a given name. I call this function from C# and specify a reference to the Blazor component, which allows me to call any function of that component that is decorated with the JS invocable attribute. The actual call of the C# method in JS looks like this. I call the function invoke method async on the object stored in the window object and specify the name of the method I want to call and the parameters I want to pass. The C# methods themselves do nothing more than store the clicked position or the new map extent in strings that are then rendered in the UI. What I also wanted to test was the interaction with the OpenLayers map from C#. So I created a button in the Blazor component and a click handler that adds a point feature on the current center of the map. I created a JS function called addPoint that expects the coordinate and creates a point feature with some styling that is then added to the vector layer of the map. This JS function is called in the C# button click handler using the JS runtime object we saw earlier. Basically, development is often quite cumbersome because you always have to write extra code to link the JavaScript code with C#. For a pure JavaScript application, this is not necessary. If you want to interact with the map a lot from C#, the code can quickly become complex. It took me some time to get a C# method defined in my Blazor component called from JavaScript, and the solution I showed you is not 100% convincing either. It is a bit easier to call a static C# method from JavaScript, but in a static method you cannot interact with the UI and you cannot use the JS runtime, so your possibilities are very limited here. On the other hand, it was quite easy to call a JavaScript function from C#. You just need to access the JS runtime object and make sure that the JS function is globally available. What I also noticed was that for some reason JavaScript errors are not written to the browser console. This took me some time to figure out because I had an error in the JavaScript code but didn't realize it because I didn't see an error in the console. So I always added a try-catch block and then manually wrote the error to the console in the catch block. Another problem I had was that in those C# methods called from JavaScript, changes to variables used in the UI did not trigger an update of the component. I don't know why, normally it worked for me, but when I was in a method that was decorated with the JS invocable attribute, it didn't work. The solution in this case is to call the stateHasChanged method, which will trigger an update of the component. So what is my conclusion about OpenLayers or any other JavaScript library in Blazor? Well, basically you have to say that it will probably work in most cases. If you just want to display a simple map in your web application that requires little interaction, you'll get there quickly. For more complex tasks, however, things can get complicated. And I have to say that even with this simple example, I sometimes struggled to get what I wanted. The developer experience was sometimes lacking. At the end of the day, as so often, it's all about what the requirements are. If you really want to work with OpenLayers but don't necessarily need Blazor, you should consider other JavaScript-based frameworks like React, Angular, or Vue.js. If you really want or need to work with Blazor, you can, but it will probably cost you a few more gray hairs. If you're interested in the sample project I showed you in this video, you can find it on GitHub. Just click on the link in the video description. That brings us to the end of this video. I hope you gained some interesting insights. If you enjoyed the video, please click the like button and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time.